Hey HubSpotters, today I'm going to be telling you about something that everybody that's using the HubSpot CRM should be doing, and that's creating custom properties for their contact and company records. So what custom properties allows you to do is store information about a contact or a company that you may not already be storing or that you may need that's not kind of built into the HubSpot default fields. So HubSpot comes with a whole bunch of properties for contacts and companies that they think are going to be helpful to you. So everything from, you know, first and last name, email address, all their contact information. But a lot of times for your company or your industry or your products, there might be some more information that you would like to collect about your contacts or your companies and have a place to store that so that you can make sales more effectively. So for example, for us, one of the things that we like to ask in a lot of the forms that our leads fill out is what their top marketing challenge is. That helps us make sure that we can deliver the right value to them when we're providing emails to them that have educational content. And when we're ready to have a sales conversation, we can talk about how we can help specifically with that challenge. So it's pretty easy to create custom properties. So I'm going to show you how to do that quick, and then I'm going to show you how you can adjust your default views for your contact records so that those properties show up in the places that you want them to show up. So the way that you do that, there's a few different ways you can get to the property settings. I'm going to show you the way that works regardless of what dashboard you're on. So if you're in the sales dashboard or the marketing platform, there's a couple different ways to do it, but regardless of which platform you're on, you can always get to your properties by clicking on your little avatar up here and going to settings there. And then we're just going to click on this properties button down here in the menu. And you can see I've got properties that I can adjust for my contact records, my company records, and my deal records. So we're going to start with contact properties. So I'm going to show you that field that I just talked about, that top marketing challenge. So this is one that we created. So you can see we named it, that's the internal name for it. You can add a description, there's different groups, so you can create new groups of information. We just have it in that contact information. And this one is a drop down, so you can select different options here, everything from just text input to a drop down. We have a drop down so that we can organize and segment our email list based on these. We don't want people just to be able to type in whatever they want. So we've got, you know, quite a few different problems that companies have with their marketing that we can help them solve. So we've got a whole list here, and then when they see this on a form, when I insert this into a form, they have a drop-down list that they can select from. Or if I want to manually upgrade it for a contact, let's say I had a meeting with them or had a phone call with them and I asked them this question, I can actually go into the contact record and choose one of these options from the drop-down list as well. So you can check down at the bottom whether or not you want to be able to show this in forms. For most fields, you want this option selected. It doesn't automatically add it to all of your forms or anything like that. Just makes it available so that when you're creating a form, you can select that option. If you're using that marketing platform, you'll probably use forms quite a bit. So the way that you create a new property is pretty easy. All you got to do is hit create a property over here. You'll give it a label, internal name, description, everything I just talked about, what type of property it is. So if it's something like a drop-down select or a radio select, it'll then give you the option to add options in here. So you can do anything like that. You could also have the option to hit this load options. So let's say you're going to load up a property that has you know, it's a property that's pretty common, so it'll just have you kind of load all the options for that. So like marital status, it loaded all the common options for companies that are using that kind of field so that you don't have to type them all out or kind of think of what those options should be. So you would just put in all this information, hit the create button, and then that field is going to be available to you. So that's kind of step one, that created the property. But it's not going to just automatically put that on the contact record page. So if I jump over to a contact record, let's actually create a property quick so I can show this quick. So we'll just do a test one, and we'll just have it be single line text. So we'll hit create. Okay, so now we have this test property created. But if I jump over to my contact record here, you'll see that field isn't listed here anywhere. So nowhere does it say test. So it might be storing that information, but it's not listed here. So most of the time when you're creating a new property, it's because you want to see it on your contact records. So you're going to want to add it to here too. So the way that you do that, you can go back into settings. All right, and then you're going to go to sales, or excuse me, contacts and companies. And then there's this option, set the properties your team sees on contact records. Again, you can do that for companies and things like that down here. But that was a contact field that we created, so I'm going to hit manage. So these are all of the properties that I see when I go to a contact record, unless I click the button. There's a button at the bottom of those. You can see all of the fields. But let's say I don't want to do that every time. I want to see this new field we created. So it was called test. I'm going to check that box. And now at the bottom of the record, I'll be able to see that field. So let's jump back and see what that looks like in my record. And there you go, there's that test field. So now I could, you know, input any value in there, hit save, and it's gonna be saved. I could also, if I've got the marketing platform, I could also add that to a form. And then when a contact actually filled out that form, it would show up here as well with whatever they filled out. So that's all there is to it, pretty simple. Hope that helps. Happy HubSpotting.